I'm here in Glyndebourne's exquisite rose garden. There are beautiful flowers, of course, but thorns as well. It's the perfect metaphor for one of Rossini's great early comedies, Il Turco in Italia. Turco has all the classic operatic ingredients. A poet with writer's block, an elderly cuckold and his flirtatious young wife, a charismatic Turk and his former lover. Rossini's biographer Stendhal wrote of this opera, "I cannot imagine imbuing song with greater lightness, joy and grace." It's hard to disagree, especially when you think he composed it when he was just 22.
To me, Rossini is wonderful because it's not just the situations that are funny, it's also the music in itself. The music is intrinsically funny. And he has a way of playing with classical codes and the prosody and the tempi dynamics. This typical Rossini crescendo, the energy that it has is always very inspiring to me.
You previously directed Don Pasquale at Glyndebourne, which is another work that has that very fine line between comedy and cruelty. Are those two elements you're always conscious of balancing, or does that emerge sort of organically from the drama?
To me, that's the essence of comedy. I think you can laugh about characters if they also potentially make you cry. And it's also got already, I find, this incredible mix that's so typical of Rossini between a genius for situation, you know, it's real situation comedy, and characters, libretto, and setting funny situations into music, but also a wonderful power of abstraction. I think those Rossini finales where everyone seems to be thinking, what am I doing here? I'm just singing, but I have no idea what's going on in my head. Have a very deep truth, because we're also in real life very often in that situation where we think, what am I actually doing today? I said that, but why did I say that? And what's going on in the first place? And that's something I really like about Rossini, and that's very present in Turco in Italia.
Rossini was one of the most successful and the most prolific composers of the 19th century. By the time he was just 38, he'd composed some 40 operas, so averaging two a year. In 1813, he premiered his first full-length comedy, and it was such a success that he immediately followed it up with Il Turco in Italia the following year. Now, there's a lovely connection between Turco and one of our other operas this season, Mozart's Così fan tutte. While Rossini was composing Turco in Milan, Mozart's opera was on stage, and you can clearly see the parallels and the echoes between them. But where Mozart's interest in the character is purely psychological and philosophical, for Rossini it's all about satire.
You know, he's making fun of things that are happening around culturally at the moment. Quite early on in the opera, the Turkish crew are arriving on the mainland, and they're rowing, and there's a sort of like the violins are going do 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 do, and they row and they're going Volga Volga, and I'm like da 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 da. I'm like, that's Don Giovanni, that's the Commendatore's theme. I was like, what's going on there? And the absolute lifting of that, which would have made the audience roar with laughter, and that's right on the nose satire. That is, you know, have I got news for you?
Yeah. There's a humanity at the root of all of it, isn't there? He's affectionate towards his characters.
Yes, I think we love all of the characters. We feel sorry, even if they're behaving like twits, we still feel sorry for them. There's the fat old man chasing after the sort of young maiden who doesn't want anything to do with him. You know, there's the young poet who's sighing and in love with someone else, and, you know, they don't love him back, and all these classic tropes. Oh, there's a great cat fight between the two women, which is is wonderful. You know, it's proper like dynasty in the pool stuff.
So at the centre of Turco, we have this heroine, Fiorilla, who is very confident, she's very sexual, she's very in control of the situation. But at the end of the piece, she has to apologise, she has to be humbled. You know, as feminists, can we still watch that and enjoy it?
I think even though she has to apologise in the end, she's quite determined and she gets away with a lot, and she's a successful heroine in her antics of being unfaithful. She's a bit like Fleabag, because she doesn't care who she hurts. But, you know, she's an interesting character because she's quite a powerhouse, and she gets what she wants. And I think Rossini knew that about women. they were the strength behind the men, and they always have been. And he kind of plays deference to that in his characters, just like Mozart did.
Italian opera in the first half of the 19th century was dominated by just one style, bel canto, literally beautiful singing. Rossini and later Donizetti and Bellini were its champions, demanding incredible vocal mastery from their singers. They were expected to wow the audience musically, while not forgetting to act. No easy feat, particularly when it comes to those garrulous old buffoons that Rossini paints with so much affectionate detail, like Don Geronio in Turco in Italia.
His music is already pure character, so he helps us to find the character with the Munich. You on the road, you know, he always follow you. Okay, this color goes this, goes that. He gives you a lot of answers because the music, it's a pure drama already.
And a big part of that drama for the comic characters comes from the fast arias, doesn't it? Those amazing coloratura comedy numbers that we all love. How do you get your mouth around them?
Well, that's difficult. It's a pattern, and especially on the language that you is not your native language, so it's quite hard to do this. But Italian language, I think, it's quite comfortable for this. I'm a Russian speaking, so we have also this a lot of consonants. Italian language also, it suits amazing on singing with the long vowels. This muscle is the most trained muscle in my body.
And how much of the character does Rossini give you, and how much is your responsibility to bring?
So the music, it's incredible. Then it comes imagination. So it's your work, your job to find the character.
And it's your third time back at Glyndebourne. Can you give us a sense of what it's like working with the company?
Even if you're working hard, and in Glyndebourne you have to do it, you always have to bring the best of you. It's very contradiction that there's such a relaxing atmosphere with the shapes, with the green, mostly green color. So you work hard, then you, after rehearsal, it's just so relaxing. It's a beautiful artist atmosphere to create something.
Giancarlo Andretta conducts a brand new production by Mariam Clément, starring Rodion Pogosov as Don Geronio, with Elena Tsalagova as his flirtatious wife, Fiorilla, bringing to life Rossini's witty, glittering Battle of the Sexes.